and restore our identity, which is Biafra. The question is, can we recover and restore our identity? Yes, we can. Because the Most High Chukwuka Abiama, God, sent our supreme leader, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. However, he assured him that he, Chukwuka, shall give us Biafra in our time. Furthermore, it is diabolical that British government under Theresa May is still arming and training terrorists such as Nigerian armed forces to suppress and kill indigenous people of Biafra just because of the oil in Biafra land. However, it is appalling that in this 21st century that some politicians and some human rights defenders and British government prefer territorial integrity to the so-called Nigeria to Biafran lives and human rights. Today, another phase of Biafra's struggle has opened by the supreme leader of indigenous people of Biafra, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. In this 21st century, Biafra are being killed by the Nigerian government under Operation Muhammad Buhari and Professor Yemi Osinbajo. However, United Nations, World Leaders, International Criminal Court of Justice, International Criminal Court are not doing anything to deplore Biafra killing. I say big shame to the United Nations, shame on the world leaders, and shame on the International Criminal Court and the International Court of Justice, for they have failed to apprehend and prosecute the perpetrators of the Biafra genocide. I also want to draw the attention of the British citizen and European citizen about the ongoing genocide against indigenous people of Biafra. Basically, what happened in the 1966 to 1970 is repeating itself again. Yes. British government is urging Nigerian government to commit genocide against indigenous people of Biafra. Yes. However, between 30th of August 2015 to date, over 10,000 unarmed Biafran civilians were killed by the Nigerian and British combined armed forces. It is not war or civil war. It is genocide against defenseless Biafran civilians. I want to remind the international community that as human beings, Biafran cannot tolerate state-sponsored terrorism against them anymore. We are putting the world on alert that we are going to defend ourselves. Enough is enough. The indigenous people of Biafra have been singled out for total extermination and extinction by the Nigerian and British government. Furthermore, if our ancestor could fight for 3 years without sophisticated weapons, imagine what we, the present generation, could do. We are ready to fight for 100 years for Biafra to come. Theological Republic of Nigeria President, terrorist Muhammad Buhari, is suffering today is because of the blood of innocent Biafrans. He killed, obviously. We will continue to suffer from one calamity to another. Basically, all we are asking is justice for the slain Biafrans. The dead cannot cry for justice. It is a duty of the living to do so for them. I, Solomon Usenebo, I swear by the Chukwuka Abiama that I shall continue to fight, campaign, and to raise awareness until justice is done. My fellow Biafrans, I want you to continue to campaign, continue to fight until we get our Biafra. The only thing we want is Biafra and not restructure the zoo called Nigeria. My aged 3 children can not only has given me perspective, but it has nailed me. My children means everything to me. It is my responsibility to make sure they are safe and happy. After seeing how over 3 million Biafran children were starved to death and over 6 million Biafrans were massacred by the Nigerian and British government under the leadership of Harold Wilson and Queen Elizabeth II, I knew immediately that I needed to help to give a voice to all the children who are victims of mass starvation as a weapon of war. We have seen the injustice done to Biafrans, and we cannot allow it to continue, not in this 2017. I shall continue to raise tremendous awareness. I shall continue to use the power of social media, and we we meet the people who obstructed Biafra genocide not to be recognized as a Biafra war, not to be recognized as a genocide. Going forward, Antonio Guterres, the Secretary General of the United Nations, tweeted on the 29th of May 2017, I quote, UN top priority is to prevent war and forge peace in world-class countries. Our peacekeeper help build security. My number one question to him is, did the United Nations make any effort to prevent Biafra genocide? Did the United Nations make any attempt to prevent Nigerian government and British government from starving over 3 million Biafran children to death? Such country, over 6 million Biafrans were massacred by the Nigerian government. Boy, did the United Nations, under the leadership of Anthony, make any effort to prevent dictator Muhammad Buhari not to suppress and commit genocide against the indigenous people of Biafra in this 21st century? For the United Nations, under his leadership, stop Biafra killings? No. Does he even make any comment or deplore the killings of indigenous people of Biafra? No, he didn't. What a hypocrisy. What a wickedness. Systematically, the United Nations is supporting the total extermination and extinction of indigenous people of Biafra. The United Nations never condemn the atrocities carried out against my people. In fact, Secretary General of the United Nations during the Biafra War consistently maintained that it was a Nigerian internal affair. The United Nations could have stopped this genocide. The United Nations could have stopped this genocide against my people instead of protecting the interests of the Nigerian state and British government. We, the indigenous people of Biafra, under the leadership of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and his able deputy, Mazi Chinefo, shall continue to fight relentlessly until Nigeria is completely defeated and fragmented. All hail Biafra! All hail Biafra! All hail Biafra! All hail Biafra!
I don't want to want to know.
All hail Biafra!
All hail Biafra!
All hail Biafra!
All hail Biafra!
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 Fellow dear friends and friends, thank you for honoring the invitation to commemorate Biafra heroes. Today we remember men, women, youths and children slaughtered for Biafra's freedom. Those heroes at a time in their lifetime confronted the burden to fight for their lives and save their people and friends from extermination. At the time they died, they were faced with the option of staying in the murderous and struggling union of one Nigeria or going back to their home, Biafra land. Their heroic action enables us to proudly call ourselves Biafrans and call our friends lovers of freedom. In their action, we draw the strength to continue the very struggle that took their irrepressible life. Our heroes gave us a head start. They proudly passed on the baton to us, and we pledge to finish the honorable race for freedom. We continue to ask for justice for them, and we vow never to let them down. We remember them because they fought a just cause. We remember them because they paid the ultimate price for our freedom. We remember them because of their effort to stop the extermination of our race. We remember them because they are our heroes. May the souls of Biafra foreign heroes rest in peace. May our Father, Creator, Chukwuoke, Dike Abiyama accept and keep their brave souls.
He said, all hell be out for. Please, we want to take a group picture.
I'm here now.
Want to know what is going on. There was a war 1967-70. The innocent citizens of Britain, open your ears.
Oh yes.
For the war, for the genocide committed against our people. British government, what a shame. For the supporting of the killing, the innocent Biafrans, just because of oil. Open your ears. Open your ears! Britain!
Say it all.
The innocent citizens of Britain! We respect you! But we want you to know the atrocity committed against we Biafrans by your government! I may say, British government are evil!
Evil!
Mankind! I repeat! British government are
evil
to mankind. What a shame for this very useless British government. I said they will never. The God we serve upon the cry of we Biafrans, British government will pay for the evil they committed against Biafra. Can you sing after me, please? All hail
Biafra!
All hail
Biafra!
Please, can you repeat after me? Britain, never can you, I can you leave
Whoa.
hail Biafra.
All hail Biafra.
All hail Biafra.
All hail Biafra.
Biafra.
Freedom. Biafra.
Freedom.
Biafra.
Ebeka Unusi.
Biafra.
Ebeka Ununaga.
Biafra. Gamarapo. Biafra. Gamebozo Gabiri. Agamarapo.
One more. Biafra is a spirit. Biafra is a naga. Durali naga, nami durali naga. Ayi bosi tu kami mburama durali naga. Ayi bosi tu kami mburama durali naga.
Biafra, 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 Biaf Bye.